Look at little
Iron Boy
Junior. Gonna cry? I just want him to be like you.
I missed the part where that's my problem.
All right, so the best news all week. Spider-Man is not in the MCU anymore. I'm over the moon about this. Spider-Man in the Disney universe has been nothing but Iron Man's little bitch. He's not his own hero. He needs constant help from other people.
Attention, people of Bikini Bottom! You have been cheated and lied to!
I knew it!
And he's not a true Spider-Man, so now he's going back home to Sony. They're going to make more Spider-Man movies, and it's probably going to tie in with Venom, and it's going to be epic. Spider-Man fighting Venom, fighting Carnage, and probably an R-rated movie, maybe? I don't know, you got Venom and Carnage, could be R-rated.
Your dreams, Alfred.
So very exciting time. We finally might see a Spider-Man that's not 15 years old anymore. We might actually get an adult Spider-Man that's over 25. I cannot wait. If anyone's played the Spider-Man video game, you already know what that kind of Spider-Man looks like. And by far the more interesting version of Spider-Man is the older Spider-Man. And with Disney, it didn't seem like we were ever going to get there. And now they could probably do it in the next movie. There's no word on whether or not Tom Holland is going to be Spider-Man for the next live-action film. They might, they might not. I would be happy if they brought back Andrew Garfield and had him fight Tom Hardy in a Spider-Man vs. Venom movie. I'd be fine with that. They really don't need Tom Holland. Because as that last Spider-Man animated movie proved, you can have multiple universes. You could have multiple Spider-Mans at the same time and it's not gonna fucking matter. And now it makes sense why they didn't announce the Spider-Man movie during the Marvel Phase 4 or 5, whatever panel that was at Comic-Con, when they fucking showed all the movie titles. Now it makes sense why there is no Spider-Man movie up there. Because they weren't sure if they were going to get his contract done or not. And it turns out Sony wants some of that money. Now Sony put out some kind of statement saying, oh, it's not Kevin Feige's fault, blah, blah, blah. But it's clear Sony just wants that fucking money. And it's definitely a good decision on their part to let the MCU take Spider-Man, make him popular again. You know, make sure Spider-Man's a $1 billion franchise. And then Sony goes, oh, we'll take that back. And we'll make a $1 billion movie. Because who's not going to go see a Spider-Man movie where he's fighting Venom? And I'm sure that's going to be the next thing on their plate. Or they're going to make a movie that builds up to that. Either way, that's probably the agenda they have right now. But just so many possibilities. I mean, everybody that's sad about this and is fighting against this, asking Sony to give it back to Disney, all those people are just dumb. They're just dumb because Spider-Man with Disney was going to be pigeonholed in the MCU. He could only do like one thing, you know? But Spider-Man on his own is his own universe. You could establish Spider-Man by himself in his own world with all his own characters and villains and stuff. And you never have to mention the Avengers. It worked fine with the Sam Raimi trilogy. Worked fine. You never once wondered where Iron Man was. You didn't give a fuck, right? You didn't need any references like that. And those Spider-Man films are still the best. The Sam Raimi trilogy, it's still the best by far. But yeah, very excited. Just wanted to give my quick reactions to the Spider-Man news. I'm so happy Disney has no control over this character because Spider-Man's an actual good character with an actual good world built around him that he doesn't need to be confined to the MCU and their small way of thinking with those movies. Now Spider-Man can get like a really good director behind him and they can actually make a great film with Spider-Man. And not just a run-of-the-mill, average child's film. PG fest that all the Spider-Man movies in the MCU have been. All the MCU movies are that. They're just these PG kiddie garbage. And so happy he's not confined to it anymore. Congratulations, Sony. You've earned Spider-Man back, even though you probably had it in the contract that it was going to run out at a certain time and you're going to get him back anyway because you're smart, Sony. You're smart. Not only did you buy Insomniac Games, which gives you exclusive Spider-Man games, but now you got the Spider-Man movies exclusively. So Sony is on the ball. They're doing a great job. And they didn't have to pay for it because they already own the Spider-Man franchise. So, oh, so good. I love seeing all the MCU fanboys and Disney fanboys cry about this. It's so good. And I can't wait till we get a really good Spider-Man film. And maybe some graphic fighting, you know? Maybe something more brutal. Because you know he's going to be taking on Venom and Carnage at some point. And this is why, you know, Sony went through with that Venom movie. They knew they were going to get Spider-Man back. So they did a good job establishing Venom. Now either you bring Tom Holland Spider-Man, or you establish a new Spider-Man, and then you have him go against Venom. Or you bring back, you know, Andrew Garfield. You do something to get to the point where we have a Venom versus Spider-Man, and then Venom and Spider-Man team up to fight Carnage, which would be dope. But yeah, that's it for now. Just want to get my thoughts about it. I'm over the moon about it. I love, love, love that Spider-Man is no longer a part of the MCU in those boring, run-of-the-mill movies that they have over there. And that's it for now. Fuck Disney, and I'll see you all in the next one. Bye.
Spider-Man does whatever a spider can. It spins a wave any size.